guys, Izzy from Endless RVing. We are at North Trails RV in beautiful Fort Myers, Florida. It's sunny, it's warm. Today we have a very popular model and floor plan. It is the Thor Magnitude SV34. So why is this such a popular floor plan? Well, it is marketed as a Super C. It is on a heavier chassis, not really your heavy duty chassis that's a true, you know, classic Super C, but this is on the F550, Ford F550, the XLT chassis. It's gonna have a 10,000 pound tow capacity. This is also a 4x4 capable vehicle, which is pretty good if you're gonna be out there out and about all types of the season. I'm gonna go and do the full exterior, and then MJ's gonna do the interior. So let's get started. Now, the total length on this, it's 35 feet 9 inches, the height is 12 feet 6 inches, and the exterior width without mirror is 99 inches. Going right up front, this is gonna be running on your Ford Super Duty, the Power Stroke. Let me give you the exact specs on this. 330 horsepower, 825 pounds of torque. The gross combined weight rating is 40,000 pounds, and the gross vehicle weight rating is 19,500 pounds. Now, this runs on diesel fuel, 40 gallons of diesel fuel on this. As we go down the passenger side, you can see front molded cap, right? All fiberglass, so you don't have the seams over here. So what that's gonna allow, it's less likely this is gonna leak, at least from those seams. Now, it's joined right here. You can see where the front cap goes. You're gonna have a big bunk up front. Full body paint on this. This is marketed to sleep 8. It might be a little questionable. You could definitely sleep 6. 8 might be tight. Go up front to the front tire. You have your Continental front tires, 19.5 inch rim. You have 225, 70, 19.5 on the tire. So right first you're gonna see you have your cab door. Nice thing about C, Super C's, you have multiple ways to get into your vehicle, and this is no different. Nice big step here, fiberglass step. They also put the kind of like that tough sticker, so to kind of protect the paint, which is nice, convenient. Let's continue down the passenger side. You can see an LED light here, not really visible during the day, but at night that's gonna give you a nice amount of lighting if you're going in and out at a dark campground. You have your camera on the passenger side. It's gonna show you your blind spots as you're going down the road. Then of course you have your entry door, fiberglass, grab handle, all frameless windows. You have a 12-year structural warranty, 6 years on the lamination. Now, if you look, we are standing under a rather large awning with LED lights. Kind of runs pretty much almost down the whole side of your campsite and your passenger side, and give you good shade. Right now, it's hot out, and there's probably a 15 degree difference between over there and over here. Before we continue, we'll give you a couple more specs. The awning size is actually 20 feet. Your fuel capacity, like I said, 40 gallons. Liquid propane is 68 pounds. Fresh water, 65 gallons. Both the gray and the black are 40 gallons. There is a tankless water heater in here, 30,000 BTU furnace, and you have your air conditioners up above. I believe there's two, but we'll know when we go inside. Now, here is your first bay. They don't put a handle, it's a little grab cable. So I like that suicide door style. You see your Xantrex 2000 inverter. Pretty good space for something this size. You have—
It does, it's very deceiving.
Yeah, this large space, and then you have something up top. It's finished out in the plastic. You also have a drain plug here, so if you get water in here, not a big deal. And pretty good on the wiring, it's not sloppy. These doors, these are aluminum doors, it looks like, and they're somewhat thick, pretty well insulated. Now, this is gonna be your outside entertainment center. I don't even know what brand that is, Konex? Kony? I've never even heard of that. Konex. Outdoor television, don't see a sound bar. All frameless windows, full body paint, of course, on something of this price point. And we'll talk about the price point at the end of the video, so you're gonna wanna stick around for that. There's your liquid propane, like I told you earlier. There's also your pump for your hydraulic, probably gonna be for your slides. You have your marker lights. This is convenient, two outlets. And now, what do we see here?
Kitchen.
Outdoor kitchen, really nice. Now, you have decent size, pretty big refrigerator here. Also with a small freezer. Cabinet up top, you have your sink, and this is plumbed, so you don't have to, it's not gonna be dumping out the bottom, and you have another drawer for some utensils here. Also two outlets. That's gonna be for your pump, I would imagine. Personally, we probably prefer just to have that storage space.
Yeah.
And there's other models store has, which I'm sure give you storage space. This is actually has good weight on it. More frameless windows, that's gonna be your bedroom window. continuing down the passenger side, this is nice. This is your propane quick connect. So if you want to set up your grill, very convenient to the outdoor kitchen, you set up your grill here and you can be grilling with all your amenities. Now, your final storage, kind of a pass-through. You can slip tables, chairs in there. You have an LED light, as well as your drain plugs, and it's all finished out in plastic. Over finishing off the passenger side, you have your fresh water fill. And now let's move on to the back. All right, so now we're on the rear. You can see large rear cap, fiberglass cap with the bedroom window, 10,000 pound towing capacity. You also have your connection for your 7-pin. I just want to show you, so this is a pretty sturdy rear ladder, 250 pound. I just want to show, just to keep that in mind, if you have hip problems, look how high you kind of, you got to have a little bit of strength here. Could be an issue if you can't get up the ladder. It is pretty high.
You'll have to add another little ladder on the ground.
Yeah, just want to let everybody know. Halogen taillights, LED on the third brake light. Let us continue on the driver's side. So you see here, this is a one slide coach. There's nothing on the passenger side. You have the full wall slide on the driver's side. It's really going to open up everything when you go inside. All right, so let's continue down on the driver's side. You have the other side of that pasture storage that I showed you a little bit earlier. And then you have your 50 amp hookup, but it's not reeled up, right? So you're going to have to really kind of fight for that cable when you're out there.
You got to work for your power.
You got to work for that power. Here's your cable connection. If you want your cable TV, it's going to go right in there. And now I'm going to assume this is for your, this is going to be, it's either fuel or DEF. I'm not sure.
It says diesel.
Okay, then it's your fuel. The DEF is usually blue. So that's your diesel. Now, I don't know what happened in here. There's some things hanging, but here's your, I don't know what that's for, but you got some controls here, another storage. All right, continuing down the driver's side. Here's your fresh water connection. Remember the other side, we show you the fresh water fill. The fresh water connection is right over to my right here. And that would be your city water. And then this is your wet bay. Here's gonna be your poles for your black and your gray. Your tanks are above, and here is your low point drain as well as your outdoor shower. Here is your Dometic. This is going to be your furnace. You're going to want to cover this up. Why? Because you get like little bugs in here, right?
The mud daubers.
The mud daubers. You have two more frameless windows. You have your Girard tankless water heater. Now, we've never really used a Girard. We had the Truma, but hopefully they work as good as the Truma does.
We've heard some decent things about the Girard.
Yeah, they've kind of evolved. I know they've had several models. They had some issues early, but it seems that they're much better now. There's actually a lot of bays here for Super C. There's your Onan 6000. Pretty big unit. There's where your DEF is. That would kind of be a pain filling up, although the slide will be closed.
Yeah.
But that's where your DEF fill is. And then the last bay, you have some more storage. So listen. It's decent storage for this.
Well, when you're looking at it, the doors look very small. I didn't think it was going to be as much storage as there was.
And it really kind of opens up on the inside. When you go inside, you're going to see it. Here's another window for that big overhead bunk, which you'll see more inside. And then, of course, it's a Ford. You're going to have your touchpad. This hasn't changed in like 20 years. This has been like the same thing. I had that in my old Explorer, remember? So you can see entry into the driver's side, power seats and everything else. So I am wrapped up on the outside. MJ is gonna take you on the inside.
And before we go any further, if you are enjoying the video so far, join our family, hit the subscribe button below. Make sure to hit the notification bell so you know when we go live and when our next videos come out. Also, we have a private group on Facebook called Endless RVing, RVers coming together. Love to share lots of things there, so come and join us there as well. See you there. Join me inside.
Use that muscle.
So you have one step, which is a little different than some.
I do want to comment on something. We didn't see batteries. I'm going to assume the batteries are right here. I'm not going to open that up, but that's more than likely where the batteries are.
All right, come on in. All right, so let's start up front. Now, if you're a big, husky person, this might be a little challenging getting under this because of the bed here. Now, so I'm tall. You really have to kind of work to get into the seat, okay?
MJ has elongated femurs.
I
That's what the doctor told her.
I've been told that. I do have long femurs. So like when I did triathlons, I would have to get like a custom bike because my femurs are messed up. Anyway, not messed up, just I'm special. All right, so here you go. You feel like you're driving a pickup truck. Pretty much looks like your truck. It's pretty spacious. Not a ton of room, but you have everything you need right here.
But you got a big hood in front of you, which is nice.
You do. So you are safe. Yes, you got three cup holders here. Okay, so in case somebody's, you know, double fisting, go for it, okay? It's good because you do have your exit doors on both sides.
One other thing I noticed right up here, you have all your auxiliary light switches. Mm-hmm. So if you want to add light bars and, you know, go crazy, you have a bunch of auxiliary light switches up above.
And here, yes. So you also have a sunglass holder. I have that in my car, actually. Yes. I like that. Now I'm going to climb out of this thing. All right, and she emerges. All right, so above that, we have quite large bunk
that
here.
Pad, yeah.
Okay, so we have this, which makes a really nice size bed. That's a big TV for a bunk area. Okay, now something special about this Thor Magnitude is it's not a typical shade. You have this dome-like shade, which I'm gonna actually take you over. Well, you keep it on there, and I'm going to show you how it opens. So on your main control panel in the center of the coach, you have a button to push that. That's a very cool feature. You're gonna get a lot of light in there. Plus you also have window on that one side with a valance here. You do have your privacy curtain, so you'll have a lot of privacy up here. One thing is missing, and we noticed a lack of on this coach, just so you're aware, is outlets and USBs. A lot of times
there's outlets, there's not a lot of USBs.
Yeah, but there's not even as many outlets as we've seen other places. So you'll usually have USBs here. You'll have them in the recliners. Mm-hmm. We're not seeing those here. So just keep, if you're an electronic type person, keep that in mind. So now moving in, you're gonna have two, you have your theater seats here, cup holders. Again, there's no outlets or USBs here. You do have a little bit of storage. Okay, some you know, basic lighting. You have your day and your privacy shades here. Bunch of storage up here.
That's a decent amount of storage.
Yeah. Yep, and you have, it goes up, so you do have like a little shelf in there. Coming onto the other side, more storage above the dinette. Okay, that's a good amount of storage. You could stack some bins in there and keep a lot of things. Now, here's your dinette, which does break down into a bed. And again, as Izzy said, it's marketed as it sleeps eight. So, you know, again, maybe if you have small kids, you could fit, you could fit a bunch of little kids up there. So that would work. So you do have this with your cup holders. You can option out a child seat, like a tether, for a car seat. A lot of people are always saying, where do I put my baby in their seat? So this, you can get optioned.
There's storage in there too.
Okay, yes.
Don't break it.
I'm not gonna break it. You got two drawers, one on each side. Okay, into the kitchen. We got a double sink here, solid surface countertops. You have the sprayer, cabinets right up above the sink. And underneath too, some little drawers there. Here's your garbage can. You have some deep drawers here, a couple of those. You can put your own silverware drawer in there. Some include it, this does not. And underneath, more storage. So you do have gas and electric stove here. So you have induction cooktop, two gas burners.
Seems to be a Thor thing.
Yeah, right? We've seen a couple like that. And then you have a convection microwave. All right, so as we move along, I just want to make note, you do have two ACs here. All right, here's your main control panel for slides, lights, the shade.
There is an autogen star in here too.
Yes. All right, then come into the bathroom. Here's your fan up above, bunch of cabinets for you. Here's your water heater control. Here's a couple outlets.
I guess say one thing Thor doesn't do, they don't like center things very well.
That bothers you.
Yeah, that drives me insane. And like the sticker's crooked.
That bothers me too. I know. Right now. So you have your power lights there. You can.
Ooh, that's their filtration.
Yeah.
That's nice.
And then some shelves over there. This does not open. Okay, but you have space over there. Okay. Your shower is your, you know, basic plastic. That has some height to it. I like this for towels or clothes or whatever you want to hang there. And you have a nice sliding door for your privacy. I like a lock better, but
with the little
it does
lock.
The job. Yeah. All right, moving on down to the fridge. You have a Whirlpool residential fridge.
That looks bigger than
and
ours.
Freezer. It does look big. I don't know if it's the way it's just set up.
Those are MJ's cookies in there, just so you know.
MJ's cookies. No, those are Izzy's cookies. Such a lie. All right, into the bedroom we go. Now, Thor does this too, where they have the tilt bed. So when this comes out, you have very little room to walk. So this is a safe space-saving bed, which is great because you then have some room there. A lot of over-the-head cabinet space all the way down. It's deep and it's high, so you have a lot of space to keep your belongings. And then on, actually just this size, you have the one where you can hang some clothes there. This is a nice size nightstand type, right? It's one of the bigger ones I've seen with a good size.
That's very large.
Yeah. drawer in there.
That's really almost like, yeah, like you can, I could store my clothes in there.
Right, right, because I take all the drawers, right? All right, here you go. It's a closet with some drawers in there. You can hang a lot of clothes.
I'm wondering if that little ladder thing is the extension.
For outside.
To get on the back, yeah. It might be.
Yeah, yeah. That was pretty high. And then you have drawers down below there, and you also have drawers on the bed. So they took some of the bed storage and some drawers, one on each side there.
So you actually get a
decent
amount here.
Yes. And then on this side, here is your TV, your bed TV. And then you have
it's
over
for
here.
For your radio.
Yeah. So you can take a look, all your controls there. Little window, you have three windows in the bedroom. You have this one looking out from the bed. You have a large window in the back that Izzy showed you, and then a smaller one on the right side of the bed. I like this area here. Actually, here's some USBs.
We're charging our batteries.
Yeah,
here.
And some drawers, but an area that you can put whatever you want there. So what is the price of this? It is $263,000.
Yeah, that is the MSRP.
263,146.
Of course, you could always try to negotiate that. Mm-hmm. If you're interested in this vehicle, or really any motorhome or RV, North Trail has access to a lot of them. Contact Tim from North Trail RV. Tell him you saw this on our channel, right? Mm-hmm. We'll put his information below. Also in the comments, let us know, do you have a Magnitude? Are you looking to get into a Magnitude or just a Super C in general? Let us know in the comments below. And for myself and MJ, we thank you guys for watching, and we'll see you on the road.